Reframing 360 videos can be time consuming, especially if you've shot a lot of footage. But with the latest Insta360 app update, you can now edit much faster thanks to some brand new AI editing features. So in this video, I'll share the top 3 AI features that have been added to the mobile app in the latest update. Keep in mind that these are more targeted towards beginners than experienced users. However, there are some cool tools that have been added in that even the pros will appreciate. This video is sponsored by Insta360, and the shots I'll be editing within the mobile app were shot with the Insta360 X4, which I'll link below. Start by updating the Insta360 app to the latest version, either in the App Store or Google Play. Once you've done that, open up the app and select a clip that you want to edit. You'll notice at the top of the editor, there are 3 different editing modes. There's AI, Quick, and Pro. And this is where the 3 new features can be found. The best way I can differentiate them is that you can think of them like beginner, intermediate, advanced in terms of how much time and effort you want to spend on your reframing. So let's start with the simplest one, and that is AI. So by pressing the analyze button down here, the app is now going to search through this clip and try to find the top highlights and any moments that might look great in a reframed video. From what I'm told, this algorithm has been improved, so expect better highlights and better AI editing in general. Once it's done, it will start playing an automatically edited video. This isn't necessarily the final product, but it's the starting point. So what I'm going to do is head down to clips, and here is where you'll find all the individual clips that the app has determined could be highlights of your video. It will save a lot of them, and it's not to say that these are all usable takes, but it's a great starting point to choose some of your favorite shots and perspectives. And if you like one, just hit export down the bottom left and either save it to your phone album or create a bigger video within the Insta360 app. At the top, you'll notice that there are different categories. So part of the AI update is that the app now recognizes specific things, like here are all the architecture related shots. There's a statue, there's a building, Sydney Opera House. So if you were, say, doing a walking tour of your city and you wanted to highlight the architecture, the app will help you identify all the architecture related shots so you can export just them without having to do any reframing. You'll also find a few other categories like selfie, forward view, scenery, and a few others. Now you can ask it to auto edit down here, and this is where it compiles a montage of all of the best angles from within your shot. You can customize these by tapping edit, and here you'll see a timeline from left to right. If you want to reposition a shot, just hold it and drag. If you want to adjust the in and out point, just tap adjust and drag the handles on the left and right. If you want to add a specific camera movement, tap movement, and here you'll find a bunch of movement presets that you can add to your individual shots within your larger shot. You can adjust the volume of your clips or just delete them if you don't like them. So again, think of this like a mini timeline where you have multiple reframe shots within your bigger project, with only the most basic ways to edit the video. You can change the aspect ratio as normal and export up the top right. Okay, so that was the most basic way to edit a video with no reframing necessary other than just following the prompts. Now if we switch over to quick mode here in the middle, there are now a few more ways to reframe. And this is similar to the viewfinder of previous apps where you tap the red button to record, except this time they've now got a joystick in the middle. So you can move your field of view around, almost like it's a video game, and it's recording every movement that you make. And then when you press stop and then watch your clip back, it's now recorded your video in sync with your joystick movements. Another great addition I've noticed with this app update is DeepTrack 3.0. DeepTrack is what tracks the subject and keeps it in the center of frame, but you'll notice that now whenever there is a subject in frame, like me or this random person walking beside me, there are now green icons that appear. If you tap one, it will automatically start tracking you, and you can then record that clip for as long as you like within your bigger clip. And again, just press stop to stop it. And now I've just recorded a brand new clip, which I can go ahead and export straight away. Now you can also use active track on inanimate objects. So let's say I want to track the Sydney Harbour Bridge. What I'm going to do is tap this icon up here and now select the bridge. Now when I press record, the app will track the Harbour Bridge. Even when obstacles get in the way, it will keep it dead centered right where I want it. Now when I watch that back, it stays centered. Again, just like before, you can change your aspect ratio down here or export your entire clip by tapping export. Now the final editing mode is Pro. And if you've been using the Insta360 app for a while, this is the most similar to what you will already be used to, where you can swipe to change your perspective, tap the plus button to add a keyframe, move your timeline forward and add another keyframe. However, one big feature they've added with this update is camera movements. So previously, if you wanted to move the camera, you'd have to manually move it like this and have the perspective transition between two manual keyframes that you set. Whereas what these camera movements do is provide a library of preset movements where you just tap it and it will automatically apply to the section highlighted on the timeline. Once you've chosen one you like, let's say I like this one here, you can either keep it at the same length, extend it by tapping and dragging, or obviously you can reduce it to be much shorter. So you could go ahead now and fill up your entire timeline with catchy camera movements and create a really dynamic video out of what was once a basic shot. So whichever workflow you prefer, whether it's AI, where the app does all the editing and shot selection for you, whether it's moving the shot around with the little joystick or using ActiveTrack 3.0, or whether it's doing the camera movements yourself with the help of these catchy movement presets, the new Insta360 app update definitely makes editing faster and better. So while these updates are limited to the mobile app for now, I'm sure it won't be too long before we start seeing them in the desktop software. What are your thoughts on these new updates, yay or nay? Let me know down below. And if you're new to 360 cameras and you want to learn how to edit an entire video from start to finish completely for free, in this video here, I'll show you my start to finish workflow that will work with any Insta360 camera.